Oh my god.
Dude. No way, bro. It's getting a little colder. I'm getting a little older. The show goes on though. No shit, bro.
This thing's savage, bro. This thing's savage, bro.
Oh shit. You know what you should do is take traction control off and book it out of here with cold tires and give us a little.
All right, what are you driving this year?
We don't see it right now.
Let's
go see it.
Come.
It's a blue pickup truck. Well, it's dirty.
Please
sorry.
Don't tell me it's the Raptor.
It's the Raptor.
Ah, yay! So sick, bro.
It's the worst car on the
grid.
Leave them here. Leave them here. We'll come back in a week.
Just when you thought that all the excitement was done, you get a slap in the face. Show goes on. Still tour. What up, puppy?
The smell of coffee and exhaust in the morning.
Man, I love it when the cars are like lined up, you know?
Oh, it's awesome.
No talk, baby.
James!
So, good morning. Welcome to Stockholm. This is Team Galag Snow Tour Volume 3, no less. So this, for me, feels like it was like last year, and everyone was like, no bro, that was 2 years ago. So I can't believe it. Things have escalated somewhat. I think Snow Tour last time, there was like, I don't know, 10 of us? Take a look down there, there's like 30 of us now, and we're already causing complete havoc here. This is the first time I've even seen this Bentley. I'm not sure of the name of this yellow, but...
Piss yellow?
Where's my co-driver?
I got in the elevator, the door opened, the Sultan saying, have you seen my key anywhere?
I assumed you meant hotel key, but if you're saying you're missing the car key, then it means car key.
What the fuck is it with him? Wait, is it in here?
So the minute the invite came in, I thought, hey, what better way to kickstart 2020 and my life post this crazy round the world trip I did than joining a bunch of idiots in the snow.
Snow Tour for me is a bunch of crazy people basically joining up in Northern Europe and driving crazy cars in the least practical snow conditions.
Some people call it a rally. Some people call it a bunch of crazy guys with cars. I just call it a great time to spend with my friends.
It's not like you see this kind of vibe anywhere else.
The buildup is unparalleled as well. You're overly excited to get back to the first city. You're overly excited to get back together with everybody. You're overly excited to start driving. You can't wait to get to an ice track.
More chaos, more people, more cars.
There's a feeling of comfort. This is a family that you're reuniting with once again.
You know, my parents always told me it's better to burn out than fade out. You know what I'm saying? And we definitely burned the tires on day one. It was an amazing welcoming. The cars, the kids, the energy, the photos, definitely seeing all the smiles. It's just something I look up to every year. And this one was just unbelievable.
Snow Tour means everything to me.
You can't even think properly when you're in your hometown because you're so excited for what's about to happen.
This is gonna be sick, I think. I mean, the lineup of cars we've got is maybe the most eclectic we've ever had. Eclectic, is that even a word? I don't know, but it is today. Look at this. Black Series with a straight pipe. Are you ready?
A screaming devil.
Mental. Like, it's insane. Like, you have to be like a crazy person driving that.
Underestimated.
Loud, fast as shit.
Underappreciated, perfect livery. Love the Pista. I'm gonna need to see my orthopedic surgeon after driving in that thing for 3.5 hours.
Beautiful.
Dumb cool.
Italian opulence.
Snow camo.
Unbelievable, beautiful.
Who has ever seen a Pista on ice?
The car you would never expect to see there. Did someone really brought a Pista on those conditions?
This year I knew I had to bring something different for Snow Tour, having come on Volume 2 and not really done that well in terms of my car choice.
The Mazda MX-5. yeah, it's a practical SUV, like, yeah. Sam is, yeah, practical.
I had to step it up a bit. When I came across this Citroën C4 World Rally Championship sort of replica.
Felt like we had a piece of history with us.
The Raptor is a big Bertha.
Badass.
Just large in every way.
If I only would have had one car for the rest of my life, it would have been the Audi R6.
Made for this.
Best car.
The Urus.
Very appropriate.
Badass.
The best. Out of the whole trip.
Audi Q8.
The GT3 RS Rally Edition.
A dream car.
Too good.
All-rounded perfection.
Pure power.
Way too loud.
Very purple, very brilliant.
Shitload of lights.
The off-road Barney.
There's a Volvo?
It wouldn't be the same going through Scandinavia without a Volvo. I drove a Volvo and had meatballs, right? So I checked off Scandinavia, right? The Bentley, you know, I love Bentleys. It was the urine green machine, you know?
The Norwegian crew this year decided to step it up and bring American muscle, which is fantastic.
Bringing the Ford GT is probably something most people wouldn't do.
Legend. Epicness.
It's only one word, it's chaos.
Absolutely nuts and so loud.
Classic.
Not practical.
Really worried if it would work, but turns out it goes sideways.
75 Corvette V8.
Understeers all the time.
The worst car you can bring to snowtalk.
That car is a compromise.
Yeah, I wanted to go even crazier. And Andreas wanted to go full comfort.
The car is super loud, it's super noisy, it's super uncomfortable, it's super unsafe, it's like a death trap. It only has three gears, it's just chasing RPMs on the highway, like ba 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 ba. You know, it's like, it's the worst.
I'll never drive that again. I think I'm the one to blame for this. That's the problem. It's my problem. It was my idea.
It's a rough ride, you know.
The Corvette sucks.
I love the Rothman Rally. That was just only a few have that blue.
I'd say it's a modern version of my favorite rally car.
Bold. Questionable.
Killed it. Two words.
Just nuts.
Magic. That car is magic.
Can't wait to try it out on the ice.
How many kilometers have you driven it so far?
40.
Today I think is our longest day. 7 hours to go ahead of us, which in Galag terms means probably about 12 hours.
Keeps getting better and better. We got 39 people joining us this year.
It's gonna be a lot of fun. There's a lot of new faces.
Let's go!
Bro, let's go!
Wait!
Okay now, from the beginning.
Then all of a sudden, before you even realized, it was underway and it was full steam ahead. Snowtalk Volume 3 has begun.
Driving a Volvo in Sweden is basically diplomatic.
It was like great just being back on the roads with the guys.
Halfway to Ora, we stopped in Sundsvall, and we're going to where all the bastards go to eat in town, Bastard Burger.
I've had this bald eagle follow me the whole time, bro, since I left.
It's cold. Finally,
welcome to Ora.
First leg done. Welcome to Ora. We're now gonna head, I believe, straight to dinner. In weather like this, gotta stay insulated, baby. Gotta stay insulated.
Like waking up in at the mountains in Ore was like, it was crazy. Like the sky was just crystal clear blue.
Ore is most charming, you know, it has a special charm to it. There's something when you hear, it's you feel the happiness in the air. And to be in a place like that, during a rally like this, is truly special.
Do you guys want to take snowmobiles to the track, or you want to drive there?
But we were in cars the whole time, so why not taking snowmobile to get to the ice track? I wanted to be part of this. I've heard that it was so much fun.
I think driving the snowmobiles instead of the cars was pretty relaxing. It was just pretty cool going through the forest and all that, being in the middle of the nature.
Day for the ice track in Ore, and then we took these snowmobiles over, and I just remember arriving and in the distance starting to hear engines, you know, starting to hear the cars going.
The ice track was nuts.
I will never get used to how much of a free-for-all these ice tracks here are.
There was elevation changes. It was not so big of a track.
You didn't have to wait for all the cars to get around.
Tommy.
This is a nice track. There's, you know, risk behind this. Amrit very kindly proved that for us.
What happened?
Speed was right, corner too tight.
Wait, that's my car!
Yeah!
What the hell? Amrit! He's free!
I missed the whole fucking breakpoint! You know what we did today?
Nothing.
We stayed on the trail. Maybe we can teach you how to do that sometime.
Like, bah, 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 and I'm like getting all the snow in my face and getting the whole barrel of snow. I was like, I just came from Indonesia surfing. This is even better than surfing.
Here we are, day two, everyone going sideways, some better than others, and just having fun, having a blast.
Epic day, a lot of awesome cars sideways, a little bit of mishap, but besides that, all in good fun, all good. That's it, that's the summary, man.
Poorly, what happened, bro?
No, bro. I don't understand.